Sharon, Brad, lovely to meet you both. How are you doing tonight?
Good. It was lovely. Nice to meet you as well.
Thank you. I'm good as well. Hi.
You good? Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Have you? You not been around London before much, have you?
Nah, just since coming out of the show. Like nearly every week. But getting used to it.
Okay. But so far, what do you think of London Fashion Week?
I mean, I'm having a great time so far. Like, I've had a really busy day, so I'm excited to see the rest of the week.
Pretty much the same. I'm only here for this one day, so I've been down to one event earlier the day, and then now this.
Okay. And have you come as a friend, or have you come as a couple?
We've come as friends. I know what everyone's going to try and make this look like. But we are just...
it's just friends, aye.
Yeah.
Friends. And is there any plans for more than that, or is it just going to be friends?
Between us, it's just friends, sorry.
Right,
I'm going to say it for him, yeah.
That's cool. And look, you know, like, so, you know, life outside of what you've been up to, how are you finding that so far?
I think it's surreal. I'm not used to it. Like, I'm not used to people knowing who you are. I'm definitely not used to people taking photos of you without asking. I'm eating popcorn on the tube and then a girl forgets to take her flash off and it's like, it's a bit awkward.
That's the weirdest thing, mate. If someone asks for a picture, then fair enough. But it's when, like, all of a sudden you'll turn and you'll see someone with a phone and then they'll, like, quickly put it away when you've caught them. Say, look, if you want a photo, just come over and ask me. Why not?
I think maybe people are a bit shy or embarrassed, you know. And, you know, I'm going to be honest with you. I've never ever in my life seen someone eating popcorn on the tube. Like, what was that about?
Oh, listen, it had been a long day. I was really hungry. And that's all I had in my bag. So, yeah, needs must and all that.
Okay, cool. So, have you got any, you know, what's the next big thing for you both? What's happening next?
I honestly don't know. As you know, I'm doing a lot of things. Like, for me, my focus is mainly on charity and things that I was really passionate about before Love Island. You know, keeping stuff that was related to my career as well. So, you know, we'll see, playing it by ear for now.
And in terms of charities, what is it that's most important to you?
You know, for me, it was always about female empowerment charities and young women, supporting young women. So I definitely want to up my work in that sphere. I was already an ambassador to a charity beforehand. So, yeah, I definitely want to do some more of that and keep working with them.
Okay, cool. And yourself, you got any plans?
Well, for me, I've just signed with my management. It took a while, but obviously I've signed.
Congratulations.
And for me, I'm just kind of passionate about what I was doing before the show. It's like, you know, going to the gym, hiking, that sort of thing. So for me to move forward in that sort of direction, yeah, it's important for me. Like, you know, again, I'm passionate about it, so it's something that I know that I can do. And then obviously, given this platform that I've now got, hopefully I can obviously push on with that.
Well, if you ever want to become a personal trainer, I can be a client straight off. You know what I mean? It's sorting out.
Sell you first.
Is it?
Alice,
yeah.
Nah, I need something. Sell you to Alice party and Alice free food. Yeah. Texas tool on you.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. I mean, Kieran over there, he's obsessed with you, bro, but you know, this is all he does. Look how much he's knowing. He even said, please don't ask them about me. But look, lovely to meet you both. I hope you have a lovely night. Lovely, honestly, lovely to meet you. Have a good one. And yeah, we'll catch you later.